Hello and welcome back to Nintendo Treehouse Live. My name is Kay and I'm here with Gabriel and Billy. We're going to take another look at The Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom. Billy, where are we at and where are we going?
We are at the Great Sky Island and we have a long trek ahead of us. We are going to try to get over to this shrine here. One of the things that I love that they brought back from Breath of the Wild is being able to tag different elements that you see in the environment and then they appear on your map so we always know where we're trying to go.
Sweet.
But as you can see, we've only got 4 hearts. We're a little early on in the game, so we've got a little bit lower level weapons. And we've already got a friend here.
He wants to play.
Yeah, that wants to hang out. And so I'm going to quickly fuse this log.
Wow. That is
it's a big boy.
Two-handed weapon, so
great. Take a sword.
And goodbye.
Oh, okay. All right.
Amazing.
I thought you were going to send him on a little flight.
I was trying to. All right, we'll do that. Try to do that to some other
poor
baddies
mother.
A little bit later. So I'll grab a mushroom right there. Oh, looks like a couple other soldiers over there. Ooh, and choo-choo.
Quick, they're distracted.
Looks like they want to have a chat with each other. And I think it's time to, make an entrance.
Just announce yourself.
Starting with
explosion.
A bang, you know. How else would you do it?
Truly.
One thing I did notice is the settings for controls are not what I needed.
Oh,
for buttons. So I am one of those people that I'm an enabler and I like swapping the jump button. So.
Oh my goodness.
So let's pick up something.
Things just explode.
Don't worry about it.
I love that Billy just created
just making an impression.
That was a very quick way to take care of those enemies. And I think that you also were able to create some red choo-choo jelly from that, too?
I think so, yeah.
So it was really, really great. And red choo-choo jelly is actually one of the best things to fuse onto arrows because they basically turn it into fire arrows.
Sweet.
So they're very valuable.
Looks like this soldier has a board fused. So I want to match that.
How convenient. There are boards just laying around waiting for you.
So when you attach a board to a weapon, you have the power of wind. And so you can also hit enemies, but they're really, really useful for crowd control.
I was going to say also the power of smacking.
Wow. That's a really powerful gust of wind.
You just did a backflip into the water. You do have to be careful because, as you can see, that
you're
is wood.
A little flammable.
So
a little flammable, and it's pretty.
Yeah, let's cool off in the water here. Oh, fish! I like fish. There we go. Get an arowana.
Nice little swim.
Yeah.
I think you should use some of those horns that you picked up, too.
I think that's a good idea because I would like to also have the ability to use my sword. So I'm going to hop into here. Let's see. Let's take this construct horn and hold it. And then we're going to drop it. And then I'm going to switch over to... Let's just use this broadsword.
Good call. That'll be fun. Nice.
And that's got a little oomph on it. So I haven't taken any damage yet, but I do know.
Somehow.
Know my skill level. So. And I do like to cook. So I am going to grab a couple items here.
What are you gonna make for us?
Yeah, let's grab.
Oh, the
some of the fish that we got.
What? Yeah.
And some steak.
Nice.
A little surf and turf.
And season that, thank you.
My mom always told me to use salt.
Good, good, good.
And we'll cook.
Looks delicious.
What a nice meal.
Delicious.
Well balanced.
Yum.
Sure.
So, I'll grab some of these things too. And I do also want to beef up my shield here.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
So that was an
That's not exactly what you had in mind, was it?
So we'll just do that.
There are two different rock types that you can fuse. One of them is more of a bludgeoning type, and one of them's a sharper edge type.
Yeah, so now that I've got a one-handed weapon, it makes it so I can also use my shield that has the rock on it.
That gives it a bit more durability. Listen, which is nice.
That's also one of my favorite shields because I'm not great at defense, but like turning your shield into an offensive weapon, into a weapon, 10 out of 10.
One of the nice things about caves is oftentimes you're going to find keys, and keys eyeballs are super helpful, especially if you can at times have bad aim.
Or if you're fighting a moving target.
Yes.
There we go.
One of my favorite additions. Well, like the fusibility is.
So that was a bubble frog. And they are new to this title. Mm-hmm. They dropped something called Bubble Gem. Collect them all.
See what happens.
So one of the things that I did see when we got in here is this rock wall here. And rock walls aren't totally new to the Legend of Zelda franchise. And oftentimes you could just use a bomb to get in there. But
bomb flowers are a limited resource.
Yeah, you don't want to, you know, I like using, as you guys are well aware, I do like using bombs and arrows a lot. So I want to save those. But by fusing this rock and this sword, we get back here. And it is, this is something that I love doing in the game. Every time I see a rock wall, I want to get back there because you'll get helpful resources like rubies. Amber that you can use to fuse to items, but you can also sell them to make serious bank.
That's a big draw for me of the caves that you can find. They're very fun to explore because they're full of these new materials and ore deposits and keys and sometimes
valuable resources.
Sometimes treasure too. And the things hiding in caves and behind rock walls are always worth going after. So it's a good idea to make a point of exploring any cave you come across.
Absolutely.
So the shrine that we're trying to get to is up there. And cool. So we still have some terrain to cover. This river right here is pretty long and pretty wide. And so I'm going to need a lot of stamina to get across it. And I know that we're this early on in the game that I just don't have it. Mm-hmm. If you did watch Mr. Aonuma's presentation, you saw that he used Ultra Hand to fuse these three logs together with the fan to make a raft. I'm not a big fan of boats. I'll be totally honest with you.
Not a big fan.
So, thanks. So I want to find a couple different ways that we can try to traverse this river.
Nice.
And so.
Ah, the floating Zonai platforms.
So, once you select Ultra Hand, everything that you can interact with turns orange, but the ones that you can actually grab that are close enough turn green. So I know I can grab this one, and I'm just going to manipulate carefully. You know.
Yeah. Right. Yep.
So I'm going to put this here, and then let's see. There should be.
Those platforms are great because they'll just maintain their altitude.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, drop this up here.
Have fun hovering.
And I want to get away from the water.
I think.
Oh, careful with that fan.
Yeah, that fan's not attached. It's going to fall. It's going to fall. Oh, no.
Okay.
Well.
But that's the thing with Ultra Hand, too. I can also.
Just grab it from the bottom of the water. Yeah, helpful.
Sweet.
You might want to stick it on the top.
That
so
is a good idea.
Off.
I didn't do it. So
that's fine. You can get up there.
Mm.
Nice.
Not attached.
So if I'm getting this right, it. Oh.
But I want to get some verticality out of this thing.
I see. So you don't want to build a regular ship. You want to build a skyship kind of thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Listen, I respect that.
Yeah. You know,
respect the vision.
Now, since that's too high for me to jump up and hop up there, I'm just going to use Ascend. And then switch over to Ultra Hand, grab the fan.
I see what you're doing here.
Manipulate this.
I love that, like, if you just look around at all the things you can interact with and manipulate with Ultra Hand, and really the sky's the limit with the types of things that you can build. Like, look at this. This is flying in style.
That's right.
This is how you cross a river.
Listen, personally, I would add maybe, like, one or two more fans, but, like, I respect the vision. It's cool.
Yeah, you have to be careful, though. The more Zonai devices you add, the quicker it'll drain your energy cell. So
exactly.
This early in the game, one fan, maybe two fans is probably all you need.
So now I've crossed the river, but I want to try something else. So what I'm going to do is grab this fan off here.
You know, this might be the only way I cross the river ever.
It's going to
be a little...
Wait, what? Like on...
On this platform.
On this platform. Yeah. Honestly, yeah.
It's so much more stylish than the logs.
It's like a nice, relaxing little trip. Too.
Yeah. Look at that.
I kept my clothes dry, too. Until I...
What were you saying?
All right. Let's see what else we can use to get over here. So... God. Okay. Let's see what we
Yeah, if you just
here.
Turn on Ultra Hand and just take a look. Look at
that.
All of those things.
There's so many options.
And like, what are you gonna do with a pot, you know?
Let's grab this.
Like, you never know. Mm-hmm. You could do something really fun with one.
Yeah, no, I appreciate how much you have to play with.
Exactly. Right? Think of the crazy things you can build with all this stuff.
Grab this fan here. I'm a fan of fans.
But not a fan of boats.
No.
Well, that we're establishing we Billy here. Lore.
Billy lore. Okay. And
okay.
Let's
okay.
see how this goes. I
absolutely
don't
have a plan here, and I'm really excited to see.
I have some thoughts. I'm curious to see if I can actually. There we go. I want to do it as far there. Perfect. Okay.
That is so precarious.
How does that make you feel?
Very precarious. I feel like.
So what I'm gonna actually mix and match a couple abilities here. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is use Ultra Hand to lift that.
Wow! Look at the reach on
crate.
That.
It's really good reach.
As
That's
far
crazy.
As I can go.
Do not fall off the platform.
And now.
Okay. Or you will drop it into the bottom of the river.
Carefully place it here. Now.
Okay.
All right.
I'm going to use another one of Link's abilities, uh-huh. and this is Recall. So I'm going to recall where that crate was, and we're going to see what we can do.
Wow. Okay, so now you're just traveling the path that you created using Ultra Hand and giving yourself some height.
Oh,
are you going to make it? Are you going to make it?
Oh, it's going to be so close.
A little short. Oh.
I believe.
Yeah, I think I got enough stamina, so I am going to make it across.
Yes.
You know, that is a
that
very
was good. That was really good.
Very creative use of the materials you had on hand.
Yeah.
I especially like the idea of creating your own updraft with the fan. We should note though that the first time you're here on the Great Sky Island, you don't actually have the paraglider, so that solution won't work. Unless you come back and try to the advanced course of river crossing.
But that's one of the things I love about this game is being able to find different creative ways and different options. I'm just going to ignore those choo-choos. find different, you know, ways that you want to accomplish objectives, whether that's in a shrine, whether you're out in the world. It's just really, it's fun to mix and match these things. If they work, they work. If they don't, you know, just a lot of trial and error, and it's fun.
It is. It's great to ask yourself, like, can I do that? Will that actually work? And a lot of the times the answer is yes.
Yeah.
And it's actually a lot of fun.
So it looks like we've got...
I also like the idea of like coming back with more resources and trying different ways to get across places.
Right,
Fun.
Okay, well, there is a captain construct down there, and we just saw it fuse something, or we're seeing it now.
A barrel?
A barrel? Or oh. not.
His buddy sabotaged
like,
it.
Nope.
I am going to attach these two logs in here because they're throwing things at me.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, now he's attempting to fuse again. Oh, he made a...
Is it a board?
A guster,
okay,
yeah.
Let's see what we can do.
What's your plan, Billy?
The Billy way.
Try a ruby here.
The power of fire.
Oh, no. Oh, my gosh.
What you going to do now?
That was absolute overkill.
Yeah, you know, a little chaos never hurt anybody.
Beautiful.
And we're just going to get out of here.
Love seeing it all go up in flames.
Well,
we're going to leave the cards behind.
Valiant effort on behalf of the constructs. Unfortunately, they were not prepared to fight Billy Berghammer.
No. So we are, we're going to hop into this cave here. And I like roller coasters, so.
We love them.
There we go. It's all about the dismount. And grab a fan. And
wow.
Sweet.
Oh, I thought that you did it this time, but it's actually a little bit off center, and that pains me in my soul.
Don't give me the business
vision.
About yes.
I support
Ooh,
it.
And
I
very,
support
very,
it.
Very
Listen, it works. Crazy. That's all we need. I guess.
She said begrudgingly.
So when you're, when you're playing Tears of the Kingdom, you're going to encounter caves that are extremely dark and also, like as you saw, pitch black. And you've been seeing me picking up these bright bloom seeds as we've been going on. Now, there are a number of ways that you can use bright bloom seeds to brighten up, literally, what you're trying to see.
There they are.
There we go. And so I'm going to drop one of these. So this is a simple way. Just grab it out of your inventory.
And whack it.
And whack it.
Sweet. Sweet.
Or.
They're so cute.
You can also throw them.
Nice.
Nice little.
That's one
impact.
Of my favorite ways to do it because it doesn't expend any resources.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, I do like expending resources, as you can see. And so you can also attach one to an arrow and just loft one into an area, and it just brightens it up. Now, that's
really handy if you're in a really big open space that's mm-hmm. dark.
Let's see what we've got over here. Okay, so that wasn't that dark, so this is pretty light. But you never know what you're going to see on the other side. There could be treasure. There could be...
Enemies?
Really scary things.
Something terrifying.
But just even attaching
beautiful.
One to the ceiling of where you're in.
Just improve your visibility overall.
It's
super
really,
useful.
It's really, really helpful. Yeah.
So anytime you find a cave, to recap, go in and take everything. Take all the bright bloom seeds and all the other stuff you can find.
Well,
yeah, absolutely.
I've been taking up a lot of gameplay time. Gab, would you like to play?
I'm so ready.
There you go.
Let's go.
Let's get out.
But first of all, I'm gonna
jump.
Okay. No. First of all, I'm gonna right some wrongs here. Not to call anyone out specifically, but I need that to not be like that.
You do you.
I think I want to use this cute little weapon that you
cute little reaper
you made. Yeah. So I see a railing here, so let's go ahead and create a fun little
ride.
Yeah. But this time what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna take out a fan from a Zonite device capsule. And so these are one use items. The fan isn't one use, but the capsules, once you take out the item, you can't put it back in. But basically, it's a super handy way to just have just resources at hand. So you can create your fun vehicles or your shenanigans
wow.
as you go. What a view, right?
I know. You're going to give Billy vertigo.
Okay, so look down.
So look down.
No, but truly.
Wow, that sunset.
The... I love the Sky Islands and just like the view from above
so
is
cool.
breathtaking. To kind of stay on task here, let me look at the map real quick because I'm someone who gets lost very easily, so I'm very happy for the pins. I guess we're going that way, but first I want to show off this fun little gadget.
Yeah.
So this is a Zonite device dispenser, and how it works is basically you can use
construct horns or zonai charges to get zonai device capsules. So I just used five soldier construct horns. And let's see, we'll get some fun stuff out of it.
When you use horns, it's a one-to-one rate, so you'll get one device for every horn you dump in. But if you use zonai charges, you get a little bit more of an increased return on your investment.
Yeah, and you just toss them in like you're cooking. Pretty simple to use, but super helpful. So as you saw, we got some fans.
Oh my goodness,
got
that's
some,
a lot.
That is a lot.
Some portable pots, and one of my personal favorites, some flame emitters.
Yeah.
Another cool thing is that once you discover these, you can actually look them up in your map. They'll be marked with this symbol, and you'll be able to see exactly the kinds of device capsules that you can get from that particular device dispenser.
And each dispenser has a different variety of devices available, so it's worth trying to seek them out, and you can make return trips to them as needed.
Yeah, absolutely. I know we have to go the other way, but, like, listen, I can't resist a Korok in need.
Aww.
You know.
He's so cute with his little backpack.
Little backpack?
Little backpack, yeah.
Homie overpacked. Me whenever I go home, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so let's see what we got to work with. I see, listen, I'm a fan of the roller coaster ride, so, like, let's...
Well, and there is a rail leading up to...
Says friend.
Korok's friend, so...
Let's do that, but, you know, we just got a whole bunch of capsules, like...
Okay.
There's more than one. Listen.
Ah! Oh. Nice catch.
It's
fine. That was insane.
What do you mean? That was totally planned.
Yeah. Great. I could not have done that any better.
And okay, this is my vision. Hold on.
Okay.
Right, let me put this here.
I mean, this is gonna be a fast roller
coaster. Excuse me.
You missed.
I would like. Did I miss again? Okay, hold on.
Third
time's the charm, indeed. Okay, and let's help our little friend. Listen, I want to give him the true, like, roller coaster experience.
You should turn him so he's facing,
like,
forward, at least. I don't think you attached
that's a good
him
call.
Either.
Haven't you ever been on a roller coaster that went backwards? You just don't know.
Attached.
Yeah, is he attached?
I think so.
No, he's not.
Oh, maybe not. Okay, it's fine. Listen.
Well, he's in the safety of the cart with you. You're fine.
It'll be great. It'll be great. That was probably for the best.
It was a very safe, very gentle ride. A little fast, but you know.
I wanted it to go a little faster, but wait, hold on.
There we go.
Okay, sir. You need to be out of this ride. Think, oh no!
Oof is
oh,
right.
No. I'm so sorry.
This poor Korok.
It's okay.
Sweating
a little bit. It's all good. It's those are
tears.
Don't you just sweat when you're having so much fun? Like, that's what's happening right now.
Yes.
Their backpack is full of pillows, so it's totally fine.
No Koroks were harmed during this little trip. It was fine.
And important Korok seeds, too.
Yes. And actually, I'm going to take go ahead and use this chance to, like, use recall to go back. Oh, right. We crashed for
It is nice that you can just follow exactly the path go backwards.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see the path before you commit. Too. So if you cast recall on something and then see, oh wait, no, that's not where I want to go, you can cancel it earlier.
Yeah, absolutely. It's super helpful. I guess we're approaching some.
Oh yeah, the cold environment.
Yeah. Okay.
Some snowy mountaintops. So cold environments. If you played Breath of the Wild, you'll remember that the cold environments will cause you damage if you're not properly prepared for them. And Gab, what are you doing to prepare for the environment?
So I just took out one of the portable pots that we got just to show it off. These are a one-time use, so it will poof out of existence once I cook on it. But I just feel like it's a really helpful addition because you won't always have access to pots wherever you are. But if you have these, you can make food on the go.
So on the go. And it's worth noting that they will also work in the rain because their fire is protected. So they are very handy to keep on hand.
Okay, so I'm cooking. What are we feeling for this meal?
How about chicken leg?
Okay, are we doing chicken?
A little and salt.
We gotta spice it. Okay.
Yeah.
I think that'll be good. Mm. You know, if I hit
chicken wings.
I'm hungry.
That means you're doing your job right.
Nice.
Ooh, perfect. So
right, pot disappeared.
Yeah. But now we can
and now
run
we're
our way.
Going into the cave rather than going into the cold environment.
Listen, I can't resist the cave.
Who can?
There, you see, there is already a potential here for discovery.
Well, and the caves are also a great place to get out of the elements, too. So if you're in the middle of a cold environment and you go into a cave, you can warm up a little bit.
Sweet. Look at that ruby. Yep. Look at all these bright bloom seeds. Listen, caves are filled with resources, as we keep saying. Like, they're worth, definitely worth checking out. Actually, well, now that I'm here, since we got some rubies, let me just, don't mind me while I do a thing.
Yeah, this is another great play style, preparing your weapons and
like
shields and such with fuse before you actually get into battle. Gives you a chance to be more thoughtful about what you're preparing and maybe experiment a little bit more when you're not in the heat of it. I
see a trend happening.
Don't mind the... Listen. Does that not...
I mean, that's really cool.
It's really cool. Thank you.
I mean...
It's my favorite kind of shield.
Yeah, it's very handy.
And, you know, we keep talking about exploring caves, but I'm over it. I got what I wanted, so, like, I'm going to bounce.
We'll leave the rest of the cave for the viewers at home to discover on their own.
I just love using Ascend to just, you know, popping out in different areas. I do like to glance around for a bit and make sure there's no...
No surprises.
Bad no surprises. It's a good chance to eat my meal.
Yeah. It is worth noting that you could have backed out, too. If you had popped out in this environment and there was a baddie waiting for you, you could nope right out of there if you wanted to.
Yeah. I just love that all these new abilities just give you a brand new way to interact with the environment and to play, right?
Mm-hmm.
I want to look at that. Can I poke it?
No.
Nope.
No.
Okay.
Stay on task.
All right. Okay.
Thank you.
Fine.
We are taking the nice off-road route over
Listen,
here.
That's where the good stuff is. Like, I haven't found anything yet, but I mean, always taking those side roads and just to see.
We're still heading in the right general direction, so.
Let's see what's up. Oh, I guess, you know, bad guys. That's
another captain construct.
I'm going to change to this.
Time to show off your...
I want
to
see...
Oh, he's fusing. What's he got? He
also embracing
you.
The power of fire. they seem like they're having a lot of fun, but I want to kind of join in.
Cooking
choo-choos. Oh, that looks...
He handled himself.
Yeah, he did. He
really
did
well.
Not need my help, but also I want that thing that you have, sir.
Please
so
be very careful.
Listen, I have the power of fire on my side.
Oh
what
my
could
God.
Go wrong? Whoa. Was that not beautiful?
Well,
that
you made very short work of that.
Very
thing.
Nice. Yeah,
wait, yeah, can yeah. you just...
Can I
show off your sword for a second?
Yes, look, I turned it into a rod of beautiful...
Fireball
shooting...
That is everything I want in a weapon. Right?
I know, but also...
And you still were able to just hit him over the head with it.
And he dropped this fun little thing.
Hold on.
I need to embrace for a moment the true power of fire. Yes.
I mean, that worked out really well, especially in a cold environment.
That was great.
That's great.
And now that you're clearly, very clearly set up for success. Okay, would you like to take over?
Sure.
You have the power of fire on your
I hand. Appreciate that. And you know, with great power comes great responsibility, and so I'm going to unequip the fire.
Kay said no.
Kay said I don't trust myself with a weapon like that. So I'm fair. Actually going to create one of my favorite shields. Yes, thank you for the reminder. And I'm just going to... Make a meat shield. That's my favorite thing to do.
My question, I have two questions.
Yes.
One, is it useful? Two, is it delicious?
Yes and yes.
Dope. Okay. I support it.
So I'm going to restock on some stuff in here.
Always take the bomb flowers.
Always.
Always take the bomb flowers. Also, always destroy the deposits.
Absolutely.
You never know what stuff you're going to find.
Also, can we talk about how beautiful this cave is, right?
Yes! Oh my gosh.
Look at all the huge tree roots.
And the mist.
Mm-hmm. Love it. This is my favorite one.
Yeah. Yeah.
For the roots and such. Mm-hmm. Let's go up and see what we have here. I think we're pretty close to our destination by now. Oh!
Fun little friend.
Hello. Hello, friend.
Friend. Question mark.
I have some tasty meat for you. Do you like it?
It likes you. Maybe
sure
a
does.
Little too much.
Oh, okay, well, but it liked my hammer better
more than
my
your
shield. That's okay. That one hurt, and it's distracted.
You didn't ask for dietary restrictions, Kay.
You're
so
right.
Clearly
maybe
that's
it's a vegetarian. Oh, boy. Okay, I'm going to just eat this surf and turf.
Yeah.
Heal up that damage because that was a lot. And we'll just take this reaper out. That seems like it would be a good idea. All right. Well, that was a like. And they are not new to the series, but they're new to this title.
I really like that they're back. I appreciate it.
They are actually terrifying,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, actually.
Like, really, like, look how gross it is. Like, is I do not
drooling?
I do not want to come across one of these in the middle of a dark cave.
No,
let me tell you.
Oh, no.
Let me tell you. This one seems like it's guarding a treasure chest. Yeah.
Do you want to go for it?
I do not. Because that is just an accident waiting to happen. So, see you later. I do not want to experience a like belly again. That was not fun. And we're coming out into the cold environment again. And I have about 2 minutes left on my cold resistance, but I don't like being on a timer. So I'm just going to put some warm sweats on. Sweet. And now I'm good to go, even if that resistance wears off.
I assume you can find those around here somewhere, maybe?
Yep, I think so. You'll have to take a look and see for yourself.
Fair.
Okay, oh, thank you for that.
Ooh, yeah. Pick up all those all those choo-choo jellies.
The Gab is all about the fire, but I'm all about the ice.
Nice. Listen, we balance each other out.
All
and
right.
Billy's just about explosions, so.
Yeah, I can get behind that, too. So we are trying to get up there. The shrine is right there, but this wall here is covered in ice. And it's a little slippery.
A little bit.
I don't think we'll be able to. I don't think I'll be able to make that, especially not with the equipment I currently have. But we do have some trees over here. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to cut down a few trees and try to make something I can climb up. I don't have an axe. I have some sharp weapons, but I don't want to really ruin their durability. But I do have this stone shield that Billy made.
This wonderful
one. And when in doubt, be a little creative and out of the box. Take that tree. Take that. And that.
Just
and
so wacky.
One of those. And can I make it?
Oh.
So close.
Well, I guess I'll just.
But this is what I was saying, right? Like, you can turn shields into
axes?
Weapons and, like, useful, like, just tools.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's really
you
helpful.
Absolutely could. So there is another sharp rock down there. So I'm going to go ahead and fuse it to my thick stick, and now I have a big axe.
Big boy axe.
Big boy axe. And I'm going to cut down one more tree because I don't think two is going to cut it. There we go.
Nice.
That was really nice. Okay, and then we are just going to fuse these babies together. And I am kind of a perfectionist when it comes to building stuff, so it always takes me a really long time. Because I'm like, no, I want it to be perfect.
Billy and I, on the other hand, are like, oh, it's on
works.
There, it worked.
Okay, this is not quite right still. It's a little difficult to do this when the logs are rolling. There we go.
I thought you did pretty great, considering it was moving.
And that's the thing I really love about Ultra Hand. It's really easy to quickly grab and manipulate items mm-hmm. and put them together, or make them do what you want them to do.
You know what? We are gonna.
That's pretty. That's pretty.
We're gonna
great.
Go with it. We're gonna yeah. we're gonna go with it. This will give me a little bit of a boost, and I'm just gonna stick it right here, and hope it doesn't fall on me. I think we're good. I felt everyone cringe on this couch. We're fine, you guys. Look, we're fine. We're totally not gonna fall when I get to the top. Hey,
we did it.
We did it.
Look at that.
We did it. That was a little precarious, but we managed to climb up the wall using our makeshift ladder. And obviously, that's not the only solution. Mm-hmm. So please look forward to being able to test out a bunch of different things. So now, with this beautiful vista here, we are at the shrine, and that's all the time we have for this segment. So thank you very much for tuning in. We've got a lot more in store for you. Sit tight, and we'll be back soon. See you later. Yeah.